described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
PBS Learning Media presents Welcome to Algebra I, representing an inverse variation algebraically.
Welcome to Algebra I. Today's lessons I want to focus on representing inverse variations algebraically. So your prior knowledge about what the equation of an inverse variation looks like is really going to help you get through this lesson. You ready to get started? Let's go.
She gets a stylus.
Okay. So just to jog your memory a bit, let's look at this example where you're asked to determine, is this relation an inverse variation? Okay?
On a screen, a table has two columns, one labeled X, one labeled Y. Vertically, in the X column, are minus 1, 5, and 10. Vertically, in the Y column, are minus 5, 1, and 1 half.
So if you remember, for an inverse variation, K was a product of Y and X, right? That was that constant you were looking for every time. So if you went through your table and you were able to see that each product for each X and Y pair was the same, then you knew you had an inverse variation situation, right? So if we tested this one out, negative 1 times negative 5, that's 5.
She writes.
Okay, 5 times 1, that's 5. 10 times 1 half, okay, let's step off to the side. 10 times 1 half, I'll make that 10, a 10 over 1 to see it as a fraction. 10 times 1 is 10. 1 times 2 is 2. 10 divided by 2 is 5.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.